Welcome to our lesson about the extruded cut tool. Let's start by creating a sketch. I'm going to right-click on this face and select Insert Sketch. Let's add a construction line and activate the circle tool. Drop it right about here, smart dimension. Let's make the diameter 12 millimeters. Okay. And exit the sketch. Previous view. Let's go to the Weldments tab now, activate the Extruded Cut tool. This is the same tool we find on the Features tab, so you'll recognize the parameters here. Our sketch is already pre-selected. For direction 1, I'm going to use an end condition of through all. At the bottom of the Property Manager is the Feature Scope control area. Let's uncheck Auto Select. We're going to use selected bodies, and we'll select these two bodies here. Let's click OK. As you see, the extruded cut was applied only to the structural members we selected. Now I'm going to create a few more holes, but this time I'll apply the circular pattern to do so. Let's edit the supporting sketch though first. I'm going to change the profile from a rectangle to a square. 150, OK, exit the sketch. Secondly, in order to create a circular pattern, we're going to need an axis, so I'm going to create one. Axis at the intersection of the front and right planes. Click OK. Now let's go to the Features tab. Activate the Circular Pattern tool. Axis 1 is already pre-selected. 360 degrees. 4 instances. Let's check equal spacing. Now we specify the features to pattern. We're going to use Cut Extrude 1. Let's scroll down to the bottom of the Property Manager. I want to uncheck Auto Select in the Feature Scope section. We'll use Selected Bodies. And under Option, let's check Geometry Pattern. This option lets us create a pattern using only the geometry of the feature, such as faces, edges, and so on. Underneath the Geometry Pattern option is an option called Propagate Visual. Check this to make your SOLIDWORKS properties such as color, texture, and so on apply to the pattern feature. Now we select the structural members. I'll select these three here and click OK. And the holes are created right through these three structural members. This concludes our lesson about using the extruded cut tool for your weldments.